G'day mates, welcome back to my YouTube channel. You may have seen it on social media, but you probably didn't believe it because it's just so insane that why would you? But we do have confirmation that last FNCS third place team on EU, Tayson, 4zr and Nayte have officially split. They came third and won $135,000 and they're splitting. We're gonna cover exactly why that is, why people think that Tayson's making the wrong choice, why Tayson is splitting with them, because of course it involves Noah Riley, Rezon, and the deal, because every massive EU team swap right now involves those three guys. And I think we have maybe found the final teams before FNCS kicks off next week, but it's also now left Tayson actually contesting his old teammates at Sweaty Sands or Believer's Beach. So this is going to be an exciting one. Also, I want to recap everything that happened today in the EU and NAE's DreamHack Cash Cup Extra. There was some insane placements and it was a really, really good day of tournaments. Let's start off by talking about exactly what happened here with Tayson and who he's now playing with. So the first information we got was Bloomy tweeted out looking for trio. If anyone was wondering, Tayson asked Rezon and Vino to play, so I can't blame them as he's the best player in the world right now. 11k PR 2021 retweets, vouchers appreciated. A lot of people just didn't believe that. They were like, wait. Tayson split with 4zr and Nayte. It kind of had a lot of people questioning, a lot of people doubting it, but turns out it is real. We then had Rezon tweet out, trio for FNCS, Tayson, Rezon, Vino, Sweaty Sands in everything. And then people were still like, look, okay, Rezon, Noah Riley, and Vidal a few days ago tweeted out that they were back together and they weren't. They have been having some fun with impression farming and saying who they're playing with, so people still didn't believe it. But then when Tayson tweeted out, for anyone wondering why we split, it was my decision. I didn't feel confident with the amount of time and effort put in the game. I think we were good trio for cash cups, but what most important is FNCS, which I didn't feel comfortable for with this trio. And again, people still thinking like, look man, like it looks real, but man, why would Tayson split up with 4zr and Nayte after getting third in the most recent FNCS and having guaranteed qualification into the finals? But we pretty much got the final confirmation we needed when Tayson tweeted out, Ken Phil for NAE's Dream Hack Extra, I'm qualled. That pretty much sold it for me because he was supposed to be playing in DreamHack Extra with 4zr and Nayte. And why wouldn't he play in like you wouldn't do that for an impression farm. So it was real. We have confirmation that Tayson has split up with 4zr and Nayte. He will be playing with Rezon and Vino and they are going Sweaty Sands. So what does that mean for 4zr and Nayte? Well, you maybe saw this coming. They've gone back with their old trio of Kezix. If you remember, they played with Kezix a few seasons ago, did really, really well, and they were the kings of Sweaty Sands. So they're not leaving either. So we now have Tayson, 4zr, and Nayte going head-to-head at Sweaty Sands against each other. It's going to be really exciting. I mean, a lot of you guys are asking what are my thoughts on it. A lot of people giving Tayson a hard time for this. They came third, and they had a guaranteed qualification spot. But, I mean, it's Tayson. He's won three FNCSs. If you can have faith in anyone to be making a good call to do well in FNCS, it's going to be him. I know a lot of people always talk about Tayson's ego. He's got way too much of an ego, but like, at what point is it just knowing your worth? He just doesn't feel confident with this team. And like he said, everyone's saying how well they're doing, but they're doing well in cash cups. We don't know how well they're going to do in FNCS yet. Tayson obviously knows they're not going to do well. That's his opinion. And it looks like from the most of what I can see, unless I missed any tweets, it looks like 4zr and Nayte aren't super upset. Like they're not complaining. They're not saying that he had an ego or they had any major issues. They're just going to play with Kezix, I guess. So, I mean, maybe they agree. A lot of people questioning how Tayson's actually going to go with Rezon. A lot of people expecting they're going to clash and have some issues. I don't know too much about them personally. I mean, like people say that, you know, everyone's going to say Tayson does have an ego. Obviously, Rezon's had some personality clashes with his teammates, Noah Riley and Vidal in the past. So maybe we'll see a bit of that, but I don't know. I just always default to the fact that Tayson has now won three FNCSs in EU. You gotta trust him, right? You gotta trust him. And that team looks phenomenal. I'm really excited to see how Tayson, Rezon, and Vino go. I think on paper, they're a fantastic team. I hope they don't have any personality issues, but I guess we'll see. But there was one little input at the end, and I don't think this is real, but I just thought it was too perfect and too funny. You had Boop tweet out, this might be the biggest IQ play by Rezon, Vidal, and Noah Riley. Split up the majority of tier 1 trios in EU, come back together one day before FNCS, and claim Sweaty for themselves. themselves, because you've got all these teams that are shambles. But I mean, I don't think that's gonna happen, but I did just think it was funny, and it was just way too much of a coincidence that basically that is what they've done. They've now split up, gone into all these different teams, created all these different teams, have them going head to head at Sweaty, and then the day before FNCS could just blow that all up. I really, really don't think they'd ever be doing that. Like, I don't think anyone has ever thought about doing that in the pro scene. People always talk about Zate being the mastermind back in the day and him always creating and orchestrating like team drama to give them the edge, but I can't see it happening. But it was just too much of a coincidence not to think it was at least funny. Like I said earlier, that does leave Bloomy looking for a trio. We also got word today that Wolfiez and Marion are now looking for a trio as well. They dropped their third, so I don't know if that would work out well or whether that would fit in, but there's still a few teams and a few players kind of floating around and looking for new teams, but it looks like everything in EU is kind of settling now, similar to what we've seen in NA East. There's still a few teams swapping around, but I think the majority of the snaking has now happened, which honestly, this is like a little bit over a week out from FNCS. In Fortnite terms, that's a pretty long amount of time. That's pretty good. At least they sorted out now instead of like 2 days before the tournament starts. This also does mean, like NA East now, EU is going to gain an extra reboot round, because obviously Tayson, 4zr, and Nayte, they came third. They had a guaranteed qualification spot into the finals. If they disband that spot, which I'm sure they will, I don't think any of them are going to try and, you know, do what we almost saw happen with Avery, where they try to, you know, not let them break up as a team, which means we're going to have four rounds for EU reboot round, because I'm guessing Queasy's not splitting, and I'm guessing Refsguard's team's not splitting either. Moving on to the Cash Cup extras, kicking off with EU, we saw Flick, Anas, and Thomas HD back on top. I don't want to say they've fallen off, because they came fifth last week, they came top five in FNCS finals, but in the Cash Cups towards the end of last season and coming into this season, they were doing very, very well, like still tier one in the region, but we didn't see them take out a win in quite a while. So seeing them come out in first on 714 points, 9 matches played, 2 wins was fantastic. They kicked it all off with a 20 elimination win. Now remember, DreamHack Cash Cup extra format is 6 points per elimination and 55 for a win. So 9 eliminations is the same as a victory out. They just got 3 wins worth of points in a single game. That is an insane start. It did make me actually raise the point. I tweeted at DreamHack Fortnite to see if maybe they had any input. I want the kind of points adjusted to maybe 3 or 4 points per elimination. I know a lot of pros agree. Some people disagree. I know it's finals round, so getting eliminations is worth a lot and it makes it really exciting. But I still feel like when you've got teams dropping ridiculous games like that and just getting so many points, it does feel a little bit odd in a final setting. Like I said, 3 or 4 points per elimination, I think would still make eliminations really, really worth it, but just not so crazy. Because you compare their match history, I'll go through it. It's a 20 elim win, 8 elim win, 8 elim 9th, 4 elim 16th, 16 elim 2nd, 7 elim 2nd, and then they had a 28th, a 21st, and a 9th place. You compare that to the first place on NA East, which is Jampa, Threats, and Rise, and you look at their match history. They had a 6 elim 4th, a 6 elim 2nd, an 11 elim 6th, 12 elim win, 10 elim 3rd, 4 elim 9th, and 10 elim 3rd. So they had an average placement of 4th. You look at Flick, Anas, and Thomas HD, they had an average placement of 9.89. They had 714 points. Jampa's team only had 661. Again, I think Flick, Anas, Thomas HD played the format perfectly. They played it super smart. Even that 28th and 21st place game, they got 5 eliminations in those 2 games for only 9 minutes spent in the game. That is huge. If you get down, just eliminate one team and then go down to the next team, you go again, that's awesome. So again, if the format doesn't change, I'm still going to love watching DreamHack, but I just do think it could be a little bit better. It's just my opinion. If you guys agree or disagree, let me know in the comment section down below. We had Andelix, Snazy, and XSweezy as well in second place on 697. Fantastic from them. Again, another team that is still up there being performing insanely well, but being a little bit quieter at the start of this season. They got a 17th. Well, sorry, this is looking at Snazy. Sorry, he got a 21st in the Trio Cash Cup, 26th in last week's Cash Cup Extra, and then 82nd in this week's Cash Cup. So for a team that last season at the start was just winning everything, bit of a slow start to the season, but a second place really does cement that confidence with them. But right now, one of the most consistent teams in the world, and definitely EU, has to be Refsguard, Andretta, and Savage. Again, in third place, another top 3 finish, 647 points, 9 matches played, 2 wins. They're looking so fantastic. Again, their match history looking pretty similar to Anas, Thomas, HDs, and Flicks. Pretty elimination heavy, good placement, but they didn't have that big first game. That 20 elim win that Flicks' team got, those 12 eliminations, that is 60 points, was pretty much the main difference between Refsguard's team and them. They only got an 8 elimination win, but still a phenomenal tournament from them. We saw Freemox team come in fourth. Unfortunately, they didn't get a Q right before the very end with DreamHack, so they could have easily won the whole tournament. Their last game finished at 5:54, so they were 6 minutes off getting their next Q. We then had Robab's team. We also had High Ground. So we had Wave High Ground, BL High Ground, and Always On Height, which is obviously Aqua's team. They looked fantastic in sixth place overall as well. We had Coral's team. Kinzel's team was up there. We had Rezumi, who's been playing really well right now. And then we had the team that just split, which is really confusing. I talked about this in the start. We had Wolfiez and Mirayan drop Pablo Wingu. So, I mean, 10th place and then they split. I don't really know. I guess the 10th place wasn't good for them. I'm going to assume that's not a placement thing. That's more of an emotion. Maybe they're not getting along well as a team. And then 11th, we had Wave Joe, Loot Boy Shadow, and then we had Tomzy. Don't freak out. Benji Fishy hasn't been dropped. He tweeted out a few days ago. He's actually gotten COVID, so he's feeling really under the weather. He's just resting. So he took the cash cup off and they found a fill and 11th place. Looking really good. Benji's teammates are looking insane. For a lot of you guys who haven't been following Joe and Shadow, they're looking good. We then had Hen, Janice, and Chappix in 14th. So what is still a good placement, still in money, top 15, but for them, probably one of their worst performances in a while, which is just crazy to think. Still playing ridiculously well, but overall, EU was really, really fun to watch. Over on NA East, I already touched on Jampa, Threats, and Ryze, and again, I have to just iterate how insane that was. Fourth place, an average placement of fourth in 7 games of DreamHack Cash Cup Extra. They played really, really well. I actually said really at the start of the tournament, they're my sleeper pick to win FNCS. They're looking so strong. I'm really excited to see if they can pull it all together. I don't think enough people are focusing on them. They did really, really well last FNCS, getting a top 5 finish. They were just outside the auto qualification for Grands, and I think they can do it again. I think they can do even better. We also had the new team of Creo, Tragix, and Illest. So if you guys didn't see this, I didn't talk about it in my video. Calc was replaced by Illest and looks like things are working pretty well for them. They came in second place on 657, probably would have won the whole cup, but their second last two games were by far their worst. So they were on a 7 elim 8th, 9 elim 3rd, 8 elim 3rd, 10 elim 2nd, 9 elim win, and 13 elim win. Like, phenomenal history. Gonna take the tournament. Their second last game was a 0 elim 26. Nothing wrong with that. 2 minutes game time. That's it. Go into the last game. They got a 4 elim 18th, and this game was crazy. Creo got taken out in a fight trying to third party Booger's team at Triple Houses. They went back in a storm to reboot Creo at Steamy. They then flew out. They got fought by Stretch's team. Creo somehow took Kanata out. Tragix and Illa stayed in Steamy stacks, and then Stretch went to reboot Kanata in Steamy stacks, got in a fight with Illest. It was just absolutely insane. Unfortunately, it was too much for them. They ended up falling. They went down early in 18th place. Came second though, so for a new team, that's a really good performance. We had Endless Oogway, which is Day, Reverse, and Miro. Again, proving that obviously they're back together. They're ready to stay. They got first place in the Cash Cup and now third place in Cash Cup Extra. Another new team formed again, obviously after the whole snakening. Nut, Iomzo, and Chucky in fourth place, looking fantastic. We had Qua, Nico, on paper, and honestly, this team is looking really, really consistent right now. I know Paper's kind of fallen off the radar a little bit with the whole social media drama and stuff like that, not being able to stream. He's been talking on Twitter about how upset he is about that. Clearly, he's channeling the frustration into the game because he is playing really, really well. So far this season, 17th in the first Cash Cup, then 22nd in the Cash Cup Extra, 11th in the solo Cash Cup, only got 93rd in the regular Cash Cup, but then 5th in the Cash Cup Extra. So they're looking really, really good to kick off the season. We had Commandment sent an Edgy in 6th place, super consistent. Stretch's team in 7th. We had Durant's team in 8th. Nosh's team in 9th. And then we had our first EU team in 10th place. Overall, fantastic tournament. Big placement from the OCE boys. You guys keep asking me, how is OCE doing? They came in 13th place. Their last game was a 3 elim 7th, which they could have gone a little bit further with, but they got a 12 elim win and a 10 elim 2nd, as well as a 4 elim 2nd. So proving they can do it in the stack lobbies. I'm really excited to see what they can do. I think they're picking up the pace. They're getting settled. They're all on their PCs, their setups. They're feeling comfortable. We had Bucky, Clicks, and Macwood in 12th. Looks like Clicks has finally fixed his PC issue. He said something about crashing during the day. Some people said he crashed in my streams. Other people said that he didn't crash and it was fine. but overall, they looked really, really good when I watched them play. They are definitely a momentum team, though. They either have huge games, like an 18 elim win, or they go down early around spawn. So it's honestly a good way to be playing right now. I really think they can fix this up. NA, just like EU, was fantastically exciting. Again, the format kind of led to those big, like, massive pop-off games, just jumping huge amounts of points. I'd like to see the consistent players kind of find themselves a bit more, especially coming into FNCS, but I would like to kind of preface that as well. If DreamHack is different and it's more of a W key with the best of the best, and then we have FNCS, there's that more set stacked lobbies, I'm fine with that too. I want you guys to know, whenever I raise these points of things I want, I'm not just assuming I'm right and it's the best decision. Genuinely, let me know in the comment section down below if you guys agree. And if DreamHack turned around and said, hey, that's terrible, we want it to be this way, I'm not going to complain at all. I just like giving my feedback when I think it could be a bit better, in my opinion. But honestly, the tournaments are still pretty stacked. They're getting sometimes active surge, not always active surge, but at least good lobbies. I just think they could be better for the top 132 teams in the region. But overall, these dream hacks are so much fun to watch. I just want to jump into FNCS because without scrims, I don't know how these guys are going to go in set lobbies. We have not seen pretty much any of these teams play set lobbies outside of smaller third-party tournaments at all this season. All right, guys, that does it for another video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please chuck a like on it. Let me know in the comment section down below your thoughts on anything I talked about today. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.